What's up, everybody? It's Steven from Status Tech, and today we are here to see if these are the best LG tones yet. If you're interested in winning a pair of these headphones, be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video because we are going to be doing a giveaway. Anyway, guys, without further ado, let's jump right in. LG first launched the LG tones back in 2012. Since then, the line has gone through several iterations and gradual design changes. When the tones were first released, they were met with a bit of hesitation due to their interesting design. However, they have easily become some of the most popular Bluetooth headphones around. They say that imitation is the most sincere form of flattery. Well, if that be true, LG should be pretty proud of hundreds of Chinese knockoffs, not to mention companies like Motorola, Sony, and even Samsung, putting their own spin on the tone design. If the box didn't have it written on the front, you would still be able to tell that LG wants these headphones to be recognized as their premium high-end headphones. Everything from their color choices to the presentation inside the box scream, "I'm valuable." But are they worth the staggering price difference in comparison to previous models, which you can find online from anywhere between half to even a third of the price of the Infiniums? Like I said before, LG wants these headphones to look and feel premium, and they definitely accomplished that goal. They come in two colors, silver and gold. I opted for the silver variant. Upon first look, they definitely have a sleek and futuristic look to them. They look like some headphones you'd expect to see in a TV show that wants to be a TV show based in the future. When we take a look at the device, you'll see that you have your play, pause, and call button located on the top of the device. Your fast forward and rewind and your volume up, volume down buttons are located on either side of the device. And your micro USB charger port, LED notification light, along with your power on and off switch are located on the inside neckband. Not to mention the highlight of this device in comparison to previous models, your earbud retractor buttons. Yes, I said retractor buttons. A very welcomed addition in comparison to previous models. Rather than relying on clips that eventually fall off and relatively weak magnets, this version of the tones offers the best form of cable management to date. The earbuds can extend about 6 to 7 inches out from the device without issue upon retraction. Honestly, I'm sure this wasn't an easy thing to include, but it seems like a no-brainer when you look at the design of these headphones, and I'm surprised it took LG this long to add this to their device. Now, one of the most noticeable differences of the Infiniums in comparison to previous iterations is its rigidity. That band is solid all the way through, and that's not necessarily a good thing. In terms of handling, you're definitely going to want to be more careful with these than previous models. No more balling them up and throwing them in a pocket or bag. These things are solid, and that's the way they're going to stay. And that rigidity doesn't really translate well to comfort levels either. One of the best attributes of the tones have always been their ability to virtually disappear around your neck because of their lightweight and flexible design. The same cannot be said for these. Now don't get me wrong, they're by no means uncomfortable or heavy. They actually feel pretty good. When we compare them to the previous models, they definitely don't disappear. I can see myself wearing these for a long period of time, maybe even up to 6 or 7 hours, but as long as the headphones are in use. Unlike the previous versions of the tones where I could just leave them on all day and forget about them, these do tend to get annoying when they're not in use and just resting around my neck. The problem is that I actually notice them. Now, if you're used to wearing collared shirts and you like to put your LG tones around your shirt collar, then their design is a little bit more forgivable, but still, just not the same. However, moving on, LG has also included a helpful little app that allows your headphones to detect and read your incoming messages, giving you the option to reply. Although the app does work with previous models of the tones, there are some specific hardware features in the Infiniums that give them a little bit of an advantage. The skip track toggles and the volume toggles also double as action buttons, allowing you to prompt the device to tell you your current time, to read you your previous text messages, to turn on and off the vibrating notifications, and to alert you of your current battery status. I did think it was really nice that the app supports multiple languages, however, I didn't really find it any more useful than just using the built-in Bluetooth voice assistants like Cortana, Siri, and Google Now. Not to mention, the app obviously can only be found on the Android market. Now, as some of you may have noticed throughout this hands-on, these headphones do bear the Harman Kardon signature logo. Now, for those of you who do not know, Harman Kardon is a company that is associated with extremely high-end quality audio devices, and the fact that these headphones have been stamped with their brand should indicate that the sound quality of this device is stellar. Now, I wouldn't really consider myself an audiophile, but I do test a lot of headphones and I can really appreciate good audio quality, and these headphones do produce a very pleasing listening experience. I don't know how else to put it other than the fact that the music just sounds clear. On some other Bluetooth headphones and previous models of the Tones, music can sound a bit muffled, as if there's a thin layer of film between the earbud and your ear. I really enjoyed the listening experience produced by these headphones. Bass is solid yet not overpowering, and when listening to things like vocals, you can really appreciate the fullness of the tones. Now, they're still Bluetooth headphones, and if you're looking for the absolutely clearest audio performance, you might want to stick with wired connected headphones. However, if you're interested in a good sounding pair of Bluetooth headphones, I don't think anyone will be disappointed here. But then again, I said these same things about the Tone Ultras, and even though I never did a review on them, I have owned the Tone Pros, and they sound pretty solid as well. Honestly, after sitting down and listening to the same songs on these three different headphones, I found it very hard to say that one was distinctly better than the others. The Infiniums do produce a slightly more controlled sound, but I don't think there's enough of a sound difference to justify the increased price tag. Now, other than that, the similarities between these and the previous versions still continue, and for the worst. It's still plagued with some connectivity issues some people call back pocket syndrome, where when you place your phone in your back pocket, sometimes the connection can get a bit choppy between your headphones and the music. Which is really strange because it doesn't happen all the time, which leads me to believe there may be a little bit of user error involved. If you plan on using these headphones away from your device, you can expect to get up to about 20 to 30 feet before connection becomes a bit troublesome. And as always, battery life on these devices are fantastic, going easily 3 to 5 days without a charge depending on usage. They're rated at 17 hours of talk time, 14 hours of music playback, with 23 days of standby, and from my testing, that sounds about right. But the problem that I have with these headphones is that although they have been slightly improved, none of these improvements really make them wildly better than their predecessors. They are good, but I'd be reluctant to say that they're worth the premium price tag. Are they the best LG Tones yet? Well, that's kind of hard to say. Like I said, they do sound a little bit better than the previous models, but personally I still prefer my Ultras. I just don't know if I can say that they're worth the trade-off. Yes, you'll get improved audio clarity, improved battery life, and those awesome retractable earbuds, but I don't know if that's worth losing the durable, flexible design of every previous model of the LG Tones. I've grown accustomed to being able to ball up my headphones and throw them in my pocket or throw them in a bag without worrying whether or not they're being crushed or bent. And I just don't know that these offer a noticeable enough improvement for me to give that up. So, there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please remember to give us that thumbs up because this video took a lot of time to make and it was not easy to get my hands on these as early as I did. If you are interested in purchasing these headphones or really any version of the Tones, because like I said, they're all good, remember to check the link in the description because like I said, these do have a premium price and you can find some of the other ones for almost a third of the price, and I definitely recommend any version of these headphones. And like I said in the beginning of the video, we are doing a giveaway for these headphones, and entering is just as simple as subscribing to our channel and leaving a comment down below. Let us know what you like about these headphones or what you like about previous versions of the Tones or what your favorite pair of Bluetooth headphones are. You can comment once per day between now and October 1st. So again guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Until next time, I'll see you later. Peace. Before the cool done run out, I be giving it my bestest. Nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn. To win some or some, but I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours. Ooh. Hey.